afterglow of a West Region championship for Louisville. And what a performance it was. 72-68 reached the final. It tells you nothing of the drama that the Cardinals delivered in front of the fans at U.S. Airways Arena. Rick Pitino's club coming from 11 down in the net cutting ceremony continuing for Louisville, who as a university goes back to the Final Four for the ninth time in search of their third all-time national championship. A great tradition after a title of cutting down the nets. Rick Pitino's group has done it many times in regional finals, but only once at the Final Four. Well, time to spin it forward now to what's coming up for our next matchup in the East Regional Final, Syracuse and Ohio State. How'd they get there? Well, Syracuse took on Wisconsin. Pick it up in the second half. Badgers were down by three, but battling. Jared Berggren, three-point play would tie it up. Jordan Taylor, the spectacular point guard for Wisconsin, showing his deep range, kept the Badgers close there. They were still down three until Rob Wilson puts the three in to tie it at 40. Scoop Jardine, scoop to the hoop, makes it a six-point lead for the Orangemen. But Ben Brust, Wisconsin loves to use that three, and it worked for him all night long. Jardine, though, a three of his own. Syracuse back up four on the very next play. An answer from the Badgers. Two men on him, doesn't matter. Taylor buries the three. With the game tied at 53, Ben Brust from the corner gives Wisconsin on Waiters with the spin move and the lay-in. That is worth another look. Spectacular stuff. Syracuse led it by one. They were up by one in the final seconds. Taylor a chance to win it with that three. And then Gosher a chance to win it with the fadeaway from the corner. Syracuse survives in a very tight one to move out of the Sweet 16 and into the Elite Eight. Here's a look at the numbers from the game. 27 three-point attempts by Wisconsin. They made 14 and still couldn't win. Syracuse playing outstanding defense for most of that game and survived an onslaught of three-pointers in order to survive to the regional final. So with that victory, Syracuse would await their next opponent, and it would be a battle of Ohio as Cincinnati and Ohio State would go at it. The underdog Bearcats coming in to take on the Buckeyes. Mick Cronin's group from Cincinnati. Lenzel Smith had a great game, scored three there, but the Buckeyes were still up. Aaron Crabb drives and rejected from behind by Justin Jackson, dragging him down like LeBron. Later on with Ohio State up 17-13. Buford. Later on, Buckeyes had the 8-point lead. Thomas stepping out for three, hitting from everywhere. Buckeyes led it by double digits. On the next Ohio State possession, look at that. Shannon Scott with a lay-in. Buckeyes continued to be up by double digits. Sullinger working the offensive. Glad it was an 8-point lead. Buckeyes at the half. Beautiful slam in there for Sullinger. Sean Kilpatrick, though, would try to keep Cincinnati within striking distance. Hits a three ball there. Then Cashmere Wright, the driving layup. Cincinnati within four. Jaquan Parker in the lane. Ties the game at 41. Cincinnati actually would have a lead here and add to it. Deion Dixon, the steal. Takes it coast to coast. A three-point Bearcats lead. What would happen to the Buckeyes? Well, they would answer. Lenzel Smith the three. Then Smith inside from Sullinger. And then Thomas, a huge Buckeye barrage late in the second half to pull away to win that one 81-66. So with that victory, the Buckeyes move to the Elite Eight. So you can see the shooting numbers nearly identical overall, though the Bearcats did have one more three-pointer. The free throw line tells the story. Only 8 free throw attempts by Cincinnati as they didn't get much going inside, where Ohio State definitely had the beef with Sullinger. Took 27 free throws, made twice as many as Cincinnati even attempted. Jared Sullinger attempting 10 of those free throws, the big workhorse for the Buckeyes, making 9 of those 10.
Siva Fallon.
So still quite a bit going on the floor of U.S. Airways Center in Phoenix, where just moments ago, Louisville with a stunning comeback to defeat Florida to win the West Region and will go to the Final Four. Here's a look at the East Region. Syracuse having come forward after the 1-point victory over Wisconsin. Ohio State a little bit more breathing room there as they took out Cincinnati. Both those games 2 nights ago in Boston. And now, in just about 10 minutes' time, they will be tipping that one off from TD Garden. And we will have that for you live here on ESPN. Well, a field of 68 has been reduced to 7 at the moment. One of those 7 already knows that they are going to New Orleans for the Final Four. They're wearing the white jerseys with the bright red trim, and they are the Louisville Cardinals. Peyton Siva, amazing story. Not only did they come from 11 points down in the last 6 minutes, they did the last 4 minutes of that game without their star point guard, Peyton Siva, who fouled out with 3:58 to go. It's all good now. They can start making plans for New Orleans and head for the Superdome and the Final Four. We'll take a break here on ESPN, and we'll get you ready for the opening tip of Ohio State and Syracuse. Side of the East Region Final, pitting Ohio State and Syracuse in Boston. Part of the March to New Orleans, the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament here on ESPN. Great pageantry that is the NCAA tournament continues here on the worldwide leader in sports. Ohio State and Syracuse about ready to tip off. And welcome everyone to ESPN's continuing coverage of the 2012 NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament. Mark Brown with you throughout our coverage here on ESPN, which will commence once again from Boston, Massachusetts in TD Garden, the home of the Boston Bruins and the Boston Celtics. But for now, a center point for the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament. Ohio State and Syracuse, the top two seeds in the East Region, have made it through to the region final. And one of the most important players will be that man right there, Jared Sullinger, the 6'9", 280-pound sophomore big man. Had 23 points and 11 rebounds in that victory Thursday night against Cincinnati, helping put his team right where they thought they would be, on the brink of the Final Four. They beat Loyola Maryland and Gonzaga before that. Deshaun Thomas, well, he was a helper up front for sure. The swingman scored inside, he scored outside. He had 26 points and 7 rebounds to help the cause against Cincinnati in what was a great battle of Ohio that in the end it was stretched out and looked like a comfortable victory, but was anything but for the Buckeyes. Well, let's take a look at Sullinger. He's not the tallest big man, but he is one of the widest and strongest and knows how to use that big frame to box out, to rebound, and to score inside. And he has done that with reckless abandon so far in this tournament. Deshaun Thomas, though, showing his versatility. He hit big threes. He scored inside. He was incredibly active in that victory over Cincinnati. And for the Orangemen, Deion Waiters in the tournament, averaging 14-plus points a game, 13 points a game during the regular season. Waiters does not start for the Orangemen, yet is probably their most spectacular offensive player. Comes off the bench and instantly becomes the focus of that Orangemen attack. The leading scorer on the season is a starter, Chris Joseph. Got great size and also great skills. He can score on the move, going to the basket, and has an outstanding touch from outside. Joseph, 6'7" senior from Montreal. And this is Deion Waiters. Great going to the basket, awesome with the pull-up jumper, and a huge weapon for Syracuse. So the stage is set, the opening tip-off, the starting lineups just moments away from TD Garden in Boston. Ohio State and Syracuse ready to go at it to see who's going to New Orleans. Averaging 77 points a game while giving up under 64. They're getting the better of the rebounding battle and sharing the ball at about 13 assists per game while stealing it from the opponent an average of 8 times per game. As for Syracuse, they use that vaunted Syracuse 2-3 zone that so many teams have been unable to solve. They're averaging 70 points a game while giving up just 62. 11 assists per game and steal at 5 per game. Syracuse, a balanced attack and a deep lineup where one of their best scorers does not even start. He comes off the bench. One guy they don't have, the 7-foot center who started all year long in Fab Mello, their leading rebounder and shot blocker, ruled ineligible before this year for the Syracuse Orangemen. John Higgins, Michael Nance, Thomas O'Neill are your officials, our game announcers in Boston. Vern Lundquist and Bill Raftery. Let's send it out to TD Garden for the opening tip of the East Region Finals, Syracuse and Ohio State.
Tip-off at Madison Square Garden. There was also a game played in the Great Alaska Shootout semifinals in 2000. Syracuse lists that game as a victory. Ohio State doesn't list it because they had to vacate the game.
Okay. And by the way, that game in 07, 9 of 19 threes. So they know how to attack the zone, and that's key. Where do they get the ball? To the foul. Nice entry. Too easy.
There's Deshaun Thomas for the first basket of the game.
Wow. We've seen him do so much damage in that lane. The big lead southpaw delivered.
Deshaun is on a real scoring tear. He had a 31 in the NCAA opener and 26 in the win the other night. But Chris Joseph in the lane with the counter.
He is a tough guy because he can do it with the bounce and stick the deep one.
Smith looks inside for Thomas again. Here's Buford, who is in a prolonged scoring slump.
Nice dive.
Oh, beautiful.
And pretty good adjustment by Sullinger.
And does he have any strength?
Well, that's what we're saying on the open. He's a tough kid, besides being agile and possessing a great physique for basketball, particularly down on the block.
Jared Sullinger, who has lost quite a bit of weight from a year ago. Here's Aaron Kraft harassing Scoop Jardine. Kraft with 6 steals the other night, tying his season high. Joseph misfires. Rebound Sullinger. Here comes Lenzel Smith Jr.
And a nice
Thomas
rebound again.
Rebound.
Nice pass.
Beautiful find. Smith Jr.
It might be on Trish on the outside there trying to help Byrne, but the ability to make passes. How about the spin away from traffic? And now this is just toughness. Out toughen the opponent. Zero delivery. Beautiful.
And the foul was on number 20, Brandon Trish, the junior from Janesville, New York. Inbound to Deshaun Thomas.
And a big thing right now is how you handle Kraft. You're going to go under, going over the top early, which should open up the passing lane at the foul line. And Ohio State has a number of people who can make plays in there.
Thomas. Battle C.J. Fair for Syracuse. Here comes Jardine, picked up by Kraft.
And Jardine should not over dribble. Kraft will force you to make mistakes. And he does right there.
There you are.
It's so tough. And you just saw Jim Boeheim go pass the ball. And this is one of the most energetic defenders. He's got a set of pipes, too. I mean, strong, tough, hard nose, and learned how to play in the backyard against his older brother and their friends. He figured to play, I got a guard, and he certainly learned well.
Here's Aaron Kraft, Defensive Player of the Year, Big Ten, entry pass,
nice
bounce
dive.
Pass. Looks like Wisconsin, offensive foul, Sullinger. Who immediately looks to the bench. He has been bothered. It's a theme for the season. Sullinger and foul trouble.
See, this is one of those weight fouls, you know? Although he did lower the shoulder at the end of it. He's so strong, it's normal for people to give ground. But once you put that shoulder in, you're going to get in trouble.
In the second game of the tournament against Gonzaga, he had to sit. There's Trish.
He's got to walk traveling. This, as good as we think the 2-3 zone of Syracuse is, somebody got the wind knocked out of him, I believe. Is that Lenzel down there?
It's Lenzel Smith, I believe.
I'm going to check a replay, I think, just to make sure it's nothing. And make sure. Oh, it's just a head. That's just a play on. That's a basketball play. Just unfortunate that the lean in and you'd be some officiating here.
Looks like Sam Thompson is going to come on for Lenzel Smith. Interesting, we chatted with the five starters yesterday. And I would think Lenzel Smith is the least publicized player of the starting five for the Buckeyes. And they had to come from behind. They lost a 12-point lead in their win over Cincinnati the other night in the huddle when they had fallen behind in the second half.
Chastised them, and he said he was really proud of them. This is what they can do. Put a lot of different people in that lane, and Scoop gets the call, I think. Trying to help out on this post guy. They love to scrape once the catch gets there.
And attention still paid to Lenzel Smith.
And the other thing on Lenzel Smith is that 30-point effort against Indiana. All of these kids step up. If Buford not playing as well lately, other people provide the lift.
That's Sam Thompson. There's Sullinger. There's Buford.
There you go. Scooty Penn, the former great Ohio State, before the game, said he texted him, told them to relax, play with confidence, and they need that deep drill three.
He was only 1-for-8 the other night, and in the last six games, 22 of 64. Here's Trish,
short
off the rim. Out of bounds, Ohio State ball.
By the way, you mentioned Thompson on the floor. We have seen him soar into the atmosphere. Very talented, up by the rim.
Jim Boeheim's gonna make two moves now. Trish will come out. Deion Waiters, probably the best sixth man in America. And Rakeem Christmas is going to take a seat, and Bai Keita is coming on. Now, we mentioned the absence of Fab Miller, and they've taken Lenzel Smith to the locker room, by the way. There's the entry pass, and Keita.
Nice trap. That's what they do, and you got to make a quick decision.
Picked off Joseph.
Pretty.
Oh, beautiful. And he missed it.
And he fouled as well.
Oh, boy.
Tough sequence. Boy, baskets, look, the look of chagrin. Chris, how could you miss that? You're in the open floor, nice run out, just a little fake, threw him off. Ended up not going to the rim, but this trap, so effective against a lot of teams, just the understanding of how to seal the baseline, come from top, and then the gimbal in the passing lane.
Buford.
That's a pass.
Putback.
I think it was
okay.
A pass.
I got
honestly do.
How about that?
I think the Thomases would agree with me.
Absolutely. I'll take that assist anytime. Seven unanswered now for the Buckeyes.
Another
Jardine. Yes.
Now that should help Scoop put it on the deck just a little bit, because that'll get Kraft's attention.
And Aaron Kraft comes across the midcourt line. Lenzel Smith in the locker room with a bump on the head. Here's Buford back to Kraft. This 2-3 zone for Syracuse. The other night, here comes another steal. Pull-up jumper, no. Thompson battles for it.
Nice
CJ
rebound.
Fair got it.
Nice weak side rebound, sealed his guy.
Keita. Jardine.
Just a nice screen and a step back. Prime time Jardine. He really likes the bright lights.
The Orange scored 6 points in 19 seconds, and that with a blown layup by Joseph.
That'll go opposite here. Oh, he had the pass too. Ohio State's got to look opposite on that elbow pass, but defensively just not the kind of help on the screen. You lay off and nylon and a Philly and some toughness.
Welcome back to Boston, everyone. It is the East Region Final as Ohio State and Syracuse going head to head to see who win the East Region and go to represent the East Region in the Final Four. Aaron Kraft had six steals in that Sweet 16 round victory to help the Buckeyes through. Got the 1-point lead over Syracuse at the moment. Let's get back to Vern Lundquist.
I watched Aaron Kraft during the playing of the national anthem. Quite emotional.
Oh, we talked about the ability to elevate. Unbelievable. Sam is the man. The lob, Kraft, terrific passer. On the floor or off? Oof. Nice
back
cut.
Cut.
Oh, missed again. Two layups now. This one by Waiters.
Waiters from close range. Here's Buford and Aaron Kraft. Waiters went for the steal. Buford puts it on the deck. Back outside to Kraft. Mentioned this 2-3 zone. And in that thrilling game the other night, Wisconsin hit 14 threes. But as Jim Boeheim noted, there's another basket. This from Deshaun Thomas. Boeheim was quick to note, yeah, but they didn't hit one in the last 7 minutes of the game.
That guy always has the answer, doesn't he? And so does Thomas, though, that mid-post, the step back, he is tough.
Jardine over Kraft.
Nice rebound right now by Joseph. Oops.
Taken away by Deshaun Thomas, and Sam Thompson wasn't ready for it.
Nice.
Deion Waiters around the world. And a foul. And the foul is called on Jared Sullinger, and that is his second.
And this normally is that spin dribble, but this time with the big guy there, the little baby hook, and Sullinger feels he didn't touch him at all. He backed off, if anything. And that is. Changes everything now. Ravenel not quite the offensive threat. Big, tough, strong, little baby hook around the rim. Beat Boston College transfer.
13-8 when Sullinger sat down with his second foul. Here's Kraft.
And there's no Smith either. And Lindsell still just got a pretty good knock.
From the corner.
How about that's what they need, William. Buford to step up. What an offensive threat and what capabilities he has.
He is the only senior starter on this team. He's hit his first two. Nice drive and another Ooh. Foul.
Wow, he got hurt on that. Went up a little prematurely. We used to have that happen to you on occasion.
Getting up prematurely?
Yeah, exactly.
Never.
Not before curfew. Put it on the deck. And Waiters just here. Just make the layup. That's the big thing. Hopefully he's okay. He's limping a little bit, ambling almost.
Randa Trish ready to come back now for Syracuse. Sullinger on the bench. Second foul. He got into foul trouble. And now here's good news for Ohio State. Lenzel Smith Jr. back from the locker room and getting ready to come back on the floor. Reaches over, gets a handshake from Brandon Trish. Six rookie cops in one gritty city. NYC 2-2 premieres Sunday, April 15th, only CBS.
Thompson got a little bit of a blow right now. Not quite the offensive threat that Lenzel Smith brings to the floor. He's back in and healthy, which is good to see.
And let's check in with Leslie Visser.
Vern, quickly, you saw Lindsell Smith came back. He was in the locker room from that headbutt. He received three stitches from Dr. Grant Jones over his right eye. Vern.
A little bit of a press there. Very fortunate not to turn it over. Deep.
Buford, his first miss. Brandon Trish up the step ladder to grab the rebound. Here's Deion Waiters. He's guarded by Lindsell Smith now.
Great with the bounce, too. Step back, a little short. In a hurry.
Good job of Ravenel blocking out, and here comes Buford. Yeah, it was a good shot, wasn't it?
Very much so. They're doing a nice job hitting the foul line, flashing people. Here comes Thomas, occasionally going under the ball screens on the perimeter for Syracuse. Driving the gas would be pretty helpful at this point. You don't have the punch of Sullinger.
Thomas,
nice pass.
Yes, it was Ravenel, and he's fouled.
Well, that is good interior passing, unselfish play, and making yourself available.
Foul is on Rakeem Christmas. Jim Boeheim making a point in a conversation with us yesterday. Here's where they miss Fab Melo most. He's the defensive player of the year. He could Smith and Keita much more prone to go with the offensive player.
Right, now, not as physical in a way.
Exactly.
The other thing you'd be saying too, Ron, is they used to extend the arms straight up, and Melo would pick up charges because of that.
Scoop Jardine takes a seat behind Boeheim. Which one is the orange?
He's very happy with this team. They've done a nice job countering some of the difficulties, including off floor as well as Melo.
We mentioned the tumultuous year the other night, of course, the charges, the allegations of sexual molestation leveled against Bernie Fine. He was fired in November. 15 seconds on the shot clock. There's the dish. Nice.
And what a cut by Christmas. And he got a present for that. Great read by the big guy.
1 point game with 11:37 to go. Grabbed closely guarded from the corner. He'll try to penetrate again.
Nice play by
Oh, the yeah.
How about him?
And one.
Bounces right back up. He likes the challenge, the little guy. Takes it to the 10. Pretty good basketball, but at the other end, the defensive balance not there for Christmas. Tough.
Well, let's take a look at the road to the Final Four. The Elite Eight taking place today and tomorrow. Look at the East and the Midwest as Ohio State and Syracuse battling. Now, tomorrow, you will see Kansas and North Carolina. The winner of those two matchups will play Saturday in the Final Four. Aaron Kraft at the free throw line, top assist man on this team with over 6 assists per game. Trying to extend the Ohio State lead. Let's go back to Vern Lundquist, Bill Raftery.
Picks up the suits for that. Anything else? Kid is tough. Great student. Those rosy cheeks like a young Vern Lundquist.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Shooter. Got to make him put it on the deck. He
Sutherland.
Is efficient. He is efficient. One bounce, and he's got your nightgown on, too. Are you a long-legged nightgown?
Yeah. Well, Sutherland off the bench. He's the 7th man on this Syracuse team. Had 2 brilliant games in the first 2. Quiet the other night in their win over Wisconsin. Here's Kraft. Lenzel Smith Jr. No. Sutherland clears it. And a chance for Syracuse to tie or take the lead. High screen set by Keita.
Look at the strength of this kid going to the goal. Wow, is that a blow by? When you have a body like that, it's incredible the deception that is apparent on the floor. You say there's no way with this physique there's going to be the ability to blow by like this kid possesses. And he's going up.
Masters live streams exclusive video of Amen Corner 15 and 16 and featured group. For more, go to cbssports.com/masters and masters.com. Well, Deion Waiters not always with this physique. He was a little overweight a year ago, challenged to work out and lose the weight. He did. He almost left the school, had a kind of a troubled freshman year, but his mom from Philadelphia, Monique Brown, worked with Jim Boeheim and urged him. Here's pressure applied by Syracuse. A lot of pressure applied by Syracuse.
Kraft called the timeout. Dad was rare too, is ready.
And we are inside the garden. And the parquet floor, the NCAA purchases 14. About the same.
It sure does. Pretty special place. Ready for the press after the timeout. Got to look up.
Kraft. That one's.
That combined with any trap below the foul line, particularly on the baseline.
Thomas back to Buford. Back to Thomas. Turnaround jumper. No.
Nice rebound.
Ravenel.
They got a foul? No. Yeah, they do. I don't think it was
Sutherland.
Sutherland, yeah, looked like it. And here at the weak side, you got to stick your guy. You can just see how far under Joseph got. Maybe a little hand check, a little Tavern League discard.
Evan Ravenel gets a pair at the line. 69% free throw shooter. Cans the first. He's a young man from Tampa, Florida, who began his career collegiately here at Boston College. Transferred, sat out last year.
Strong kid.
That one, Sullinger went out with his second foul. Ohio State was leading 13-8. That was at the 13-30 mark.
Tells you how deep they are, I think. Very talented, nice penetration. That's something that he can do extremely well. Just not settling three. The slash of Joseph.
Chris Joseph from Montreal, Quebec.
Well, you two really hit it off. Thinking French. And
that is their first lead.
How about the ball screen to the empty side and no weak side attention? Pretty look.
Ravenel wasn't ready for it. It was tip.
Now John Higgins put it the other way. They can't check for this. Little full court pressure at the ball.
Yep.
Wow, I never saw a tip. Now one official must have felt the ball was misdirected. They're just stationary now with Thomas on the line.
By Keita from San Luis, Senegal. Right side. It was not on Kraft. It was called on Ravenel, and it's his second. Ooh. So the two big bigs, each with two. Jardine at the line. He and Waiters both from Philadelphia. He gets the first. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes, he's not only the best tennis player in the world, he is the most entertaining. Novak Djokovic's amazing life story tomorrow on 60 Minutes per game.
We're watching them practice out in Columbus early in the year saying, who is this kid? Yeah, they have a lot of nice pass. And there he is around the rim, he's saying around the rim and a finger in. That's his game.
Detroit.
And he shoots around 37%, I think.
Ooh, ouch.
Doesn't get there often. Not bad looking.
Well, he's now 9 of 25. You're right.
Mm-hmm. But there's a big upside. His stroke doesn't look unattractive. And their bigs are having their trouble, aren't they?
Wow.
And poor, feel terrible. The Jared Sullinger, you know, a nickel dimer at the end to get him out with the two.
Unsuccessful trip for Amir Williams. Well, thus far in the first half, on the left, Sullinger's played 6 minutes. On the right, Ravenel has played 5 minutes.
Same play.
Waiters, no.
Nice.
Kraft, good job, block out.
We talk about Sullinger's derriere. That was a crafty move. And a little kick here, Waiters, I think.
Ooh. It was Waiters. His second.
You can get into that lane on occasion, and the Waiters, you get them on a wrong angle, you can blow by and get into gaps.
Lenzel Smith Jr. averaging only 6. Mentioned in the telecast the other night, he lit it up against Indiana at home when he scored 28. Get coverage of the Division I Women's Basketball Tournament at NCAA.com/Final Four. Lenzel Smith Jr., the sophomore from Zion, Illinois.
Very engaging, weren't they, the kids, both
yes.
teams?
Yeah, both teams, and we had the pleasure of talking to them as a group. And interesting to watch the byplay
mm-hmm.
of these kids nearing the end of a very long season. with so much at stake in this one. Here's Chris Joseph, number 32.
Oh boy, he really attacked there. Cuda once again, got to go strong though.
Loose ball, Lenzel Smith Jr. has it. Tied at 23.
The perimeter of Syracuse is not involving the bigger guys here. Fair on the floor, as well as Joseph. I think we're gonna do some damage to the guards finding them.
Buford gets to Thomas.
And look how far out on the shooters Syracuse will come. They yeah. know.
Jardine back on Kraft. Lenzel Smith puts it on the floor. Floater, no, short.
Nice screen out there by Fair. A little sarcastic chant there by the Syracuse fans on the out of bounds.
6:38 remaining at a tie game at 23-all.
That's got to feel real good. Pinned down because of Sullinger being on the bench, still hanging tough. And they go the other way. Yep,
they do. Offensive call. It's on Trish.
Trish thinks he may have been in that restraining area. But it's always the secondary defender. Drive, draw. I think he was there.
Boeheim is apoplectic on the far side. Technical foul called on Boeheim. He was halfway to center court.
I think Jimmy feels he was in the restraining area.
Buford will shoot the technical fouls.
Ooh. There's a guy you count on at 83%. And goodness, I guess he never got that left foot down. It's tough to see from our first angle. And he's pretty much under control generally.
And so he'll be taken in by Buford and Kraft.
Now Jimmy's got to be careful.
Thomas, Kraft, Amir Williams, Buford, Lenzel Smith on the floor for Ohio
nice
State.
Play.
Beautiful.
Oh, everything.
And he missed it.
Everything, but was that well executed? Hit the box, dive, and nobody back. Nobody back. Just fell asleep.
And so Scoop Jardine finds C.J. Fair, and the Orange are back in the lead.
They've been doing a nice job taking advantage of the exchange on the wings. Sliding somebody to the corner.
Kraft gets it in the corner, back outside Smith. 10 on the shot clock.
Nice play.
Kraft rejected by Keita.
Too deep.
Jardine screened from Keita.
Ooh, that's
jumper
deep.
Joseph. No foul call. There was contact.
The other way, Keita, pretty good checkouts. The ability to get in the lane, and right here, you can just see nobody recognizes. Guards have to pay attention, turn and look at the rim, and the inexperience shown by Williams. You got to sprint, looking over your shoulder, get back in position. Send it in.
Well,
more than fair.
Amir Williams just missed two. And already with 5:15 to go in the first half, Ohio State shoots in the double bonus. There's one. Well, this might become a game of attrition. Look at the quartet on the right with two fouls each, Sullinger and Ravenel. Sullinger's played 6 minutes in the first half, Ravenel five.
That does speak of the depth, though, doesn't it? That both clubs can turn to some people and keep a balance. Do a nice job on their post rubs of curling, like just there.
Yes, indeed.
And look at this. Nice play. Great presentation. Amir, a presence.
Let me do my Bill Raftery impersonation here. With authority.
Well, you know, the first with authority.
Yes.
Derek Coleman.
Really?
Yeah, it's the first. Going back, I mean, he just took over. He was a presence. He was the law around the rim.
Derek Coleman's in the building, now working with Dave Bing, Jim Boeheim's former teammate and roommate at Syracuse, as mayor of New York. That one knocked out of bounds.
That's right.
Detroit. Yeah. Not quick correction on that one.
Well, he might have a shot there, too.
Buford knocked that one into the stands. 25 all.
Nice hands off. It should be
over.
There
we go. Kraft again. Lost control.
You just can't relax around that kid. Look at the arms on him. It's not only his footwork, but his strength. Great arms and hands as a football, as a quarterback would have. His persistence is incredible. Just couldn't latch onto that one.
This is quite a battle with Jardine and Kraft, isn't it?
So I would let somebody else beat him, and here's a back cut.
6 seconds on the shot clock. A prayer thrown up, off balance, and a rebound to Amir Williams. Quick pass.
Try and beat the zone down. Not a bad idea.
Back outside to Kraft. Now the zone will have a chance to set with 4.5 to go. There you are.
What a great look, and Amir sealing his guy. Terrific play by Williams, the rookie.
I don't think he came to the arena tonight thinking I'm going to play half the first half.
You know, they work so hard in practice, and the competition for both teams is so good. You're prepared no matter what, but I think you're right. It's just a great understanding right in here of turning that back. And a terrific entry look from the top. Get it to the foul line. That's the one area you want to come up and play. You're going to pay deep.
And now at the line, C.J. Fair, who had been in a prolonged slump in the last 6 games. He came out of that slump in the win the other night. And he gets the nice soft bounce on that one. Fair with 15 points. He was 6 of 7 from the field.
Jimmy yo-yoing now with the fouls you alluded to earlier. Key to getting the blow. They're coming in with the key Christmas who had started.
Chatted with these guys yesterday, and C.J. Fair was one we said, well, you broke the slump. He said, spring break is over.
And he's right.
4 minutes to go, first half.
He hasn't been able to get many looks on the offensive end. There's that overload. Yeah, what a nice job Thomas has done finding people. I think he got caught. I think he got caught.
Williams having a tough job finishing. 3:47 to go, tied at 27.
Here's a look at the brackets as we look at from the Elite Eight to the Final Four. That's where these two teams are trying to get to out of Boston. Let's send it back to Vern Lundquist and Bill Rafter.
Oh, excuse me, Bill.
I'm sorry. They had Kraft take it in. They put Big on the ball. Joseph, he couldn't see. Now they switch it. And this is usually for Buford. They get him the ball on some sort of a screen, but against the zone, it's not as easily done. And they try and pin him, and a good reaction.
Renzel Smith, Buford, Thomas now at the free throw line. There's the entry pass. He tries to dish it to Williams, and it's knocked out of bounds. How about Aaron Kraft so far?
Well, he's not the only passer, Thomas. Kraft, he just really gets after. He's so disruptive, causes turnovers. And how about this? Sam the man elevating big time. And then the ability to bang, take the hit, body search, and finish. Little kiss by the crafty kid.
Smith Jr., Buford, pump fake, Fair out on it. This is not a particularly adept three-point shooting team. They've got one at that could be a shot clock violation.
Yep.
It is.
Well, and also they're stepping so far out, you can't step into the jumper. I think the best way to do it is go inside, the defense collapses a little, and then maybe the kick out. And obviously any offensive rebounds, you can really do a job by kicking them out as well.
And we saw Wisconsin the other night in that thrilling game against Syracuse. They canned 14 from three, but this Ohio State team only 33% of the season.
Tough shot.
Yes, and Williams gets another rebound.
Great defense.
Here comes Kraft. That's 4 rebounds here in the first half for the freshman Amir Williams.
I don't know if Williams will be that good for that. They do the right thing. They got Thomas on the foul line.
Yeah.
Better decision maker. Here's the roll.
Skip pass in the corner. Kraft saves it. Buford, pull-up jumper way off the mark.
Just didn't get squared on that space dribble.
Well, Buford has been in a slump. It's not a mild slump. And he had a huge game in East Lansing, hit the game winner as Ohio State knocked off Michigan State to form a three-way tie. But that was the last really good shooting game he had. He was 8 of 14 in that one. Nice touch pass. Here's Buford again.
Just couldn't finish it.
How about Christmas? Coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg, Kenny, and Charles, and Kansas State head coach Frank Martin will analyze how Louisville made it to the Final Four. They'll speak with Kentucky's John Calipari and Anthony Davis as they prepare for tomorrow's South Regional Final with Baylor. Plus, there'll be a Naismith watch update. AT&T at the half. Under two to go here. Tied at 27.
Nice look. And a dive again. They did a good job with that, haven't they?
They sure have.
And Williams, Amir, I apologize. Pretty good catch. And then the find by the big fella.
Yeah, it was a nice interior pass.
Sure was.
That one is knocked out of bounds by Amir Williams.
Being in the right spot, I think they've done a great job down here on that baseline, getting rid of it before the trap happens, and that's the read you have to have against the Cuse.
Joseph. On the floor, we've got Trish, Joseph, Jardine. Haven't seen all that much of Deion Waiters in this half. That one's short.
Another tough shot. Him under duress.
Yes.
Not free-flowing.
Buford into the corner. Jumper Thomas tipped.
Are they up? Both Christmas and Williams. A quick timeout by Jimmy Boeheim.
1:16 to go in the half. Well, we were watching the interview at the end of the Louisville triumph over Florida. Of course, Patino over Donovan. You could just feel the emotion in Patino's countenance. Here's Trish.
Nice pass.
Beautiful.
And nice five. I love the way Trish straightens out and attacks with the shoulders right at the rim. You got to pay attention. And a nice seal for the delivery.
Little wraparound from Trish and the fifth tie. Williams back outside, too strong. Turnover.
Tough angle on that pass. A little inexperience showing there, but just terrific use as he gets into the lane now. Everybody, no slide down the front in the low post. And Christmas, time of year.
Thad Matta, eighth season as the head coach at Ohio State. Interesting, his background was in basketball only colleges and universities. Graduate of Butler, also at Xavier, and when he was offered the job at Ohio State, he wanted to determine the impact of football on a basketball program, so he contacted two schools, Texas and Florida.
Not a bad start.
No, not at all.
And now with a chance to hold it late and an opportunity for Ohio State to get it back if they do a good job on the D and rebound. A little run out late. And you got to be careful with Kraft because he may strip you in this open floor. Good move.
Waiters. Short. 5 seconds to go. Buford. Jardine is back. Clean takeaway by Jardine.
And what a job on the other end by Williams. Doing a lot of extra work. And right here, just moving the body. Great defense. And extraordinary hands at the end, and nice job. Waiters couldn't finish. Jimmy gets him out without the foul. Be careful of the lob. You got Sam the man in there, Thompson. A little screen and get him to the rim.
Stop. Thompson, number 12, back to Kraft, puts it up.
Got a fun half, huh?
Sure was.
Competitive.
And I think Thad Mata's got to be happy.
Absolutely.
He got to the halftime tied with his star playing only 6 minutes in the first half. Let's go to Leslie Disser.
In a burn- one in a very tightly officiated game. Jim Boeheim drew his first technical of the year. Coach, what did you see in the first half?
We didn't take advantage offensively. We didn't get to the basket enough. We got him in early foul trouble. Then we never got to the one-on-one. We settled for too many jump shots. Our defense is good, but our offense has got to get going.
Thank you, Coach. Vern.
All right, Leslie, thank you. 29-all.
And welcome back to ESPN's continuing coverage of the 2012 NCAA Men's Basketball Championship. The big story in the first half, besides competitive hard-nosed basketball, was Jared Sullinger, the big star for Ohio State, having to sit early and for the rest of the first half with the two fouls. Scoop Jardine made two of his three-point shots, but not much else from the outside was coming from the Orangemen, who were just one of 16 from outside of the paint. Both teams getting about the same number of bench points. As we look at Ohio State's Jared Sullinger, what they're missing: 17.5 points, 9 rebounds per game in 30 minutes per game. This is what he's done in the first half: 4 points, couple of rebounds. He's played only 6 of the 20 minutes. Picked up that second foul. His head coach, Thad Matta, saying, hey, I'm going to play it conservative. We're going to play it safe. I'm going to sit my big man so I have him for the rest of the half, of the second half, rather, so they don't risk the chance that he would get a third foul. So we'll see if that strategy pays off. It would appear to have paid off so far. Even without their big man, they've been able to stay even with the number one seed in the region, the Syracuse Orangemen. 20 minutes to decide who's going to the Final Four. Let's get back to Vern Lundquist and Bill Raftery.
Jardine back to C.J. Fair.
I would think Syracuse will move the ball a little bit more, do some things like get into the high post, let Fair go to that dominant hand, that left hand with a little kiss. We need some settling down on the offensive end.
That foul called on Deshaun Thomas, his first. And C.J. Fair is at the line.
Pretty competitive game, Vern. I think right now settling into what you can do on the offensive end. They both have a feel for one another. I like what Ohio State's been able to do passing the ball, entering at the high post, and doing a great job on the baseline.
Now Sullinger back on the floor.
And I think he can be physical down below. I think guys will go to him just a little. Here's got the pin.
Buford has missed his last 5 shots.
So much for that.
A nice runner. And what about Sullinger? Well, the thing about Sullinger is when he's in the game, a lot of attention is paid, and it opens up other areas for the Buckeyes.
Where you go? Joseph.
Where you go?
Slips.
Well, he's been forcing the issue, I think, just a little bit too much. But that little runner baseline, you can just see everybody stepping up. A nice little slip by Sullinger. But that floater, and Jim Bain, I'm not really happy. Chris Joseph got to get his game organized a little bit.
Chris Joseph, we asked the team yesterday, who does the best impression of Jim Boeheim? It was unanimous that it was Chris Joseph. Now he can pretend he's a mirror and talk right back to him. That will not happen.
Go strong.
Sullinger.
There you go.
Nope.
With the line, though. That's what you want.
Fouls on Rakeem Christmas.
And Vern, he's a load down there. He's got that ability to hold off people. And as noted earlier in the broadcast, it's not mellow, so he can be a little more physical, turn that shoulder. He gets sneaky elevation on his release.
Well, his mom and dad are here. We mentioned that he lost a lot of weight last year. His mom said, don't lose your posterior. It's very important to the way you play.
He uses it mightily, I might add.
Ohio State back on top.
Abraham lamenting the fact they weren't running their stuff, settling for jump shots. There's that driving and replace. Look at the hands of Kraft.
Kraft tried to track it down after he deflected it. Now Jardine goes left.
Alley-oop. Nice play. And they iced it. Force it one way. Kraft And of course, the entry with the bounce, experience prevailing on the lob.
I'm really interested in what Frank Martin had to say in the studio at the half. Watch out for Jardine in the second half. He's averaging 11 points and 3 assists. Jardine, this is, in the second half of tournament games so far.
I think I'd take Frank on a stare down with Charles, wouldn't you? And Buford really stepping up now, taking advantage, putting it on the deck, supplying that leadership.
And that is the fourth foul on Christmas. It's Country Music's Party of the Year, the Academy of Country Music Awards, live Sunday, April 1st, only CBS. Two for Buford, and a 2-point lead again.
Nice little show and hedge in the hands by Kraft. A little overzealous.
That's his first.
He just contains penetration. And the one time earlier that Scoop went to the hoop, there wasn't any assistance on that forced one side. Here they force it, and they get some help and recovery.
Sutherland, number 43. Wow, what a tough shot, in and out. Now that was closely contested. Here's Kraft.
A little hands here. Nickel dimer by Jardine.
Second foul on Jardine.
It's interesting, the ability to turn the corner and just a little touch and
you know, that wasn't even a nickel dimer.
Woolworth's
was
close.
I don't know what's left. That's a penny nickel.
Bargain basement.
Wow.
Now they're ready to go opposite, but they move positions.
Appropriate since we're in the home of Filene.
Ooh.
Lenzel Smith, Jr. Timeout. Syracuse. Now, Deion Waiters is back on the floor and running the point. Jardine moves over to the right side. Waiters only 1 for 5. He and Joseph poor shooting in the first half. Joseph was 2 for 9, and Joseph still has a seat on the bench next to Jim Boeheim.
Excellent defense on that whole trip. A lot of shows. They're worried about ball screens. And down to 5.
Here's Jardine, spin move. Off the front rim, rebound, Keita, short.
Got to make that.
And it's saved for Ohio State.
They got a double dribble.
Double dribble, wow.
You know, I think he looked up, but I don't think he touched it. What happened, they had a run out at the other end. And let's see if he's an honest Dave. What do you think? Let's see if that hand, oh, close. Awfully close. And he's saying, honest. They didn't. Tough.
Waiters. Sullinger had to back off a little bit. And Waiters is now 1 for 6. Buford with
Senior.
A high dribble.
Senior.
Yeah.
Right at, and he's hanging tough, and he gets fouled. Now, if you're a freshman or sophomore, you're going to fan dribble
right
and wait for the collection of the troops. Gets to the rim, he's bigger too, with the backpedaling guards.
Buford, a 4-year starter for the Buckeyes. This is one. Oh, that's his second miss today. And the third foul on Sutherland. So Chris Joseph is on, not for Sutherland, but for C.J. Fair. And Buford, one more.
And you can see when Joseph is off his game or Waiters, it's a different Syracuse team. They've been forcing the issue, not able to finish. Jimmy rested Joseph. Now he's got him back. There's the baseline rubs and forced a deep catch away.
Chris Joseph.
On the floor on Buford.
Yes.
You can see Joseph's ability, not only with the speed, but the strength. to turn the corner. He's just got to wait and get it at the proper angle. Don't do it immediately.
Jim Boeheim, 36 years. Next fall will mark his 50th year on the campus at Syracuse, with the exception of a couple of years playing for basketball team in the Eastern League. How about Waiters? He's now 1 for 7.
Yeah, just not finishing the bigs. Sullinger with a good presentation.
Here's Kraft with Thomas, Lenzel, Smith. This is the starting five on the floor for the Buckeyes of Ohio State.
36 years. How many jokes you think he's told?
Two.
Nice ball fake. And back to his hand.
Oh, what a nifty move, and the putback is good.
And loading up underneath is Sullinger, who occupied two people to let Thomas finish.
Largest lead of the game now is 8. Into the corner, Sutherland. Yes!
Boy, did they need that. Resuscitation with the high leg pants. Should go through Sullinger. Got to give him touches. Good things happen. There he is.
Yep. And they find it.
There you go. Just too strong and gets the angle. Keita down on delivery. Look at the footwork.
Jardine to Joseph. Buford's on him. Jumper, top of the key. In and out.
He knew he missed, too. Did you see him running?
Yes, I did. Lenzel Smith Jr. with a big rebound.
Oh, what happened over there? Kraft hit the deck.
Sutherland and Kraft had a collision. I'm not sure what happened, what caused it.
Well, they're doing a good job with their overload, running baseline. Look at this sneak.
Back it comes. Here's Sullinger again.
Wow, wow.
Oh, my.
A double smooch.
Whoa.
You think he's got some pent-up emotion sitting on the pines for 14 minutes.
Waiters.
Well, they give him the charge. I don't know how deep that was from our angle, but Kraft stepping up, and right here, the power of the big fella. Puts you on the deck, takes the whole front line, decimate him. Give him the touches, he'll provide the lift.
Now Jared Sullinger, artistic depiction of him. You can see the intensity there too. He's playing, as Bill said, with a lot of emotion here in the second half.
And controlled emotion too. I mean, he's forceful, aggressive. And I think sitting all that time, how about those folks?
On the left, Satch, he's feeling the beat.
Ooh.
And Barbara, Jared's mom, on the right.
They got numbers. Nice play. There you go.
Oh, hit hard and goes down.
Lenzel's taking a lot of licks, hasn't he?
Yes.
Early on, he got a bang in the forehead, but just doing a terrific job moving the ball by Kraft up the sideline. And Thomas was ready to stop, but you can see the retreat is not there with the white shirts and everything, but on the release, Smith did it 10.
And Lenzel Smith Jr. goes to the line. 60% for the year. Watch every game on the road to the Final Four live on your computer, iPhone, iPad, and select Android phones with NCAA March Madness Live. Get more information at ncaa.com/March Madness.
Yeah, but watching Thomas run, he got banged a little bit in that first half, stretching his leg to Sean. It's maybe quieted him on the offensive end.
Here's Waiters, who's had a tough afternoon, evening rather, and Jardine.
Nice pass.
Oh, beautiful
nice
pass.
Hands. How about Kraft? Oh, the kid never gives up on a play.
He splits the photographers, thanks the fan in the front seat, and then tries to go underneath. I think he had a little too much emotion.
I agree. And a nice run out here, and he's there again.
And he got called for the foul, yeah.
Second one, I think you're right. stayed away for too many pictures. Pretty hands, though. I mean, that's just an amazing effort.
Wow.
What's not to like?
Well, I love the fact that he's in his second year at Ohio State. He's a pre-med student.
I got another cheapie there on the.
Wow.
That's where I would love the force out back. That's one of those you really don't want to call that, but you have to. It caused the turnover.
So the third for Kraft. We mentioned early in the contest that his brother Brandon being deployed to Afghanistan tonight as an Army infantryman. Whoa, that's huge.
That was like a guy that knows how to play. A nice timing, patient maneuver. First the space, and now the body search. And terrific analysis and converting. And they need his steady play coming down the stretch.
Well, just think of the last minute or so, the last possessions. You had Kraft saving the ball from going out of bounds, getting a little over anxious with his attempt to get it inside, and then picking up two quick fouls. And now Joseph hits the three-pointer.
And they got the small change on the sideline. Waiters number three.
Whoa.
And Jimmy's got to be careful again. Boy, they are really picky.
Jimmy's got the NCAA committee chairman right in front of him.
And having
Jeff Hathaway.
And having a dialogue with him.
Yep. There's Hathaway.
If I were on the committee, I think I'd sit other spots.
That's Waiters
fourth. Fourth, excuse me. Does that change things?
Here's Jardine. Jumper.
I don't know whether it's such a hurry. Relax and run your stuff. There's 13 minutes left. They have not run their double high where they screen and get a double screen or go to high low. Nutrition, maybe to bring him some semblance of order.
On the right, Waiters, Christmas with four, Sutherland with three. Kraft picked up two inside of 40 seconds. Jardine kicks it back out. Trish, got it.
The kid's always ready to play. He is a big time gamer. Off the pines with a nip result.
And he's got a huge smile on his face. Entry pass, Deshaun Thomas, knocked away by Keita.
Nice
loose
pass.
Ball. Sullinger shoots two.
Well, you can see the emotion. The crescendo rising, but the ability to get your feet organized and drive the gap, all the heads turn. Good organization, a beautiful looking stroke, and his temperament and smile. Pretty good.
Well, his father is here. And at the line, Sullinger shoots two. Ooh. Sutherland has to take a seat on the bench because he's picked up his fourth foul. Waiters, Sutherland, and Christmas with four. Sullinger shoots one more from the line.
Put that graphic of offensive rebounding seven. That's so key against that zone. And these wide bodies coming up with anything on the floor as well. A little bump again. Wow. This one's on Lenzel Smith, I believe.
It is. His first.
Well, this is when you're behind, you love this opportunity. Step to the line, the one and one clock stops. It also gets you set for your pressure, which they've been so good at after free throw, Syracuse.
Trish's uncle Howard was a starter for Syracuse back in the 80s. And played in the game in which Indiana knocked off the Cougars. Keith Smart comes to mind.
Does he? A nice interception, almost
saved by Kraft.
Go inside. Sullinger looming at the foul line.
Kraft. Smith Jr.
Got it. Nice play by Kraft, though. Just enough to set him up.
Jardine. There's the switch. Sullinger. Entry pass. C.J. Fair.
Nice fill, and Fair gets to the line. Well, that's really nice basketball. Two played one. The dive so important. But Kraft, just a nice job. He just turns a little bit to get the defender off. And nylon from deep by the lefty. Smith.
Largest lead of the game was 10. And Fair shoots two. Sophomore out of Baltimore.
They do a nice job getting him going to his left as well. Solid with the ball screen. The defense helps in the back, and they get him coming off.
Hands them both. 4-point margin. On the floor, Kraft and Buford, along with Lenzel Smith Jr., Thomas and Sullinger, starting five. And for Syracuse, Jardine, Trish, Keita, Chris Joseph, and C.J. Fair.
Trying to get the overload on the left and get Sullinger on that block. He's got to run to the ball.
There he does.
Yeah, yep. Their timing's just a little bit off.
Thomas finds Sullinger. Fade away.
I thought he made it. And look at Trish digging down. Creates the habit for Fair to wrap it up.
Back to Trish. Huge three a while ago. Joseph.
Inadvertent whistle, I think. I think that happened a little anticipation of some action when Trish had the basketball.
Jim Boeheim, 36 years as the head coach at his alma mater, Thad Matta, in his eighth season. Miss, tip, Sullinger, and into Kraft's hands.
Why not ride the big fella?
Keita overplays him, so they find Thomas, puts it on the floor, got it.
Ooh, nice cut. He does a nice job. See him ambling, though?
Yeah.
He's not full tilt.
Did you see Aaron Kraft urging him? Come on, come on. Get back here on defense. Chris Joseph, guarded by Buford.
Tough man. Nice cut again by Fair. Look at Kraft. Always got his body and hands in the correct spot for denial. He plays a number of guys, as we said the other night, just a terrific grasp of defensive technique.
Had six steals the other night. That equaled his season high. He's got one tonight. Oh, beauty!
Boy, nobody stepped up in the back.
Wow!
Got sealed off.
Little Matador defense there.
It sure was. It's called, oh, hey, not Olay. Help me. You know, you're in trouble.
Sullinger, Joseph backs down on him. Here's Buford, jumper. Oh, boy.
Nice big presentation by Keita.
Now Trish.
Don't need anything.
Back to Jardine. He pulls him back out. 8:50 to go.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Either way, they forced him, and no squeeze off the dribble and no attention to detail at the rim.
Jardine has 11.
Somebody's got to come at him when he's around that rim.
Nope. Tipped out. Kraft has it. Fresh 35. A two-point game.
Sullinger not as active. That could be fatigue right now. He might be looking for that TV timeout.
Buford. Thomas.
Nice defense.
Beautiful.
Charge. Thomas. Nice to have a home crowd. Goodness. Providing some energy, but the defense providing the lift. A counter with the block and the sacrifice by Joseph.
And so Thomas will head to the bench with his third foul, and Ravenel comes on.
You feel like you're in the dome?
Oh.
Same play, a little better D. A little too much dribbling.
Joseph push.
A good call.
Oh, did they get Kraft? They did.
Or Buford, I think. Let's see.
Oh, Buford. It's 4-4, not 4.
How about this? Afraid to get that foul, little ball fake. And scoop. Thinking he's back in South Philly doing some damage.
At the moment, as Syracuse on a big run to try to even this one up. Right now, a one-point Ohio State lead. Let's get back to Vern Lundquist and Bill Raftor in Boston.
Shot. Kraft and Buford. Thomas, three fouls each.
Thomas not quite as active for some reason. They're bottling up Sullinger.
Keita's doing a good job on him, don't you think?
Yeah, they double. Just to get him, kick it out. They had him if they did it.
Yeah, they did.
Dumped it down.
Three on the shot clock.
Got it. Lenz, how about this kid? He just plays confidently. Sticks that three. Also a terrific cutter. And that's him small. What a tough shot this is. A little early.
Loose ball. Joseph. Back to Trish.
Back to Trish. Wow. I just love that kid. I mean, he is amazing. If Jimmy plays him, he's okay. If he doesn't play him, he comes in late. Whatever you need, coach.
1 point game. Clean block, held ball. Possession arrow goes to Ohio State.
Can't say enough about Keita. His activity, his footwork, but on the other side, because waiters with foul problems, you turn to Trish, who provides a terrific lift. Two threes, a few foul shots. Just incredible and tough on this end as well. I think he can go with that left hook. Nice kick.
Lenzel Smith, fall away. That wasn't a fadeaway. He was off balance. Had a chance for the Orange to claim the lead for the first time since they led by two in the first half.
Goodness. A little quick, maybe. I thought he was going to use his drive pull-up.
Sullinger with the rebound.
They got to move for Kraft, I think. He'll get him the ball. He's the best post passer. That's part of the difficulty, I think. If he was on the side with Sullinger, maybe they could get better entries. There they got him. There you go, the big fella. A little kiss. Wow.
5.5 remaining.
Boy, punch, counterpunch, Vern.
Couple of pretty good teams. Trish.
Nice help that time.
Keita. And a foul underneath.
Sullinger, I think, if they give it to him. No.
It's on Lenzel Smith Jr.
Chose others.
His second. And so Keita, by Keita, the sophomore from Senegal. He is at the line.
68%. Getting organized here.
Oh, he's had a valuable game. 10 rebounds and 3 blocks tonight.
Ooh, goodness. Wow. When you have a kiss from the foul line.
Yes.
You've got some help from above. Well, we're in.
No. I heard him call that.
Red Arbank used to say it's your best friend. Now I know what the backboard is. He loved the bank shot.
Yeah.
I don't think he was quite thinking of that.
Buford clears the miss. Now the wing shooter should really give passing lanes that are easier. Buford, Smith, then Thomas on the air. There you go. Sullinger, double team from Joseph. Pretty back good. Outside. He wants it again. He's got it again. And he's fouled again. That was patience. Solid offensive basketball. This is because you've got the outside shooting. And when he puts a foot in that lane, he is very tough. Location. The Land Baron. The big derriere. And then the drop step and the kick. He's a little bit fatigued, though, I think. He's taking a little time inhaling. He's got to carry a few pounds around out there. Not easy. At all deference. 2 for 2 this trip. The old coach up there.
Oh, he was a great one, wasn't
he? He sure was.
Northland High School.
Nice cut. But the
quick hands. Turnover. That's 8 turnovers for Syracuse, 10 in the game for Ohio State, 4.5.
When you leave your feet, that's generally something that may happen.
Buford hit his first 2 shots tonight. Here's Sullinger.
Oh, they got the
push. Oh, boy.
I don't know. Come on. See.
Wow.
Don't blame me for mumbling over there.
That's the 4th on Kia. Christmas has been out most of this half with his 4th foul. And Sullinger is back at the line. Double bonus for Ohio State. This year, enjoy more madness with Coke Zero. Text MAKEOVER to 2653 for a chance to upgrade that TV room with an ultimate entertainment system. Christmas back on the floor, number 25, the freshman.
Yo-yo the 2 bigs down the stretch here.
Sullinger 1 of 2. And the Ohio State lead is 5.
Big trip for the Cuse. Solid D important right now.
4 players with 4 fouls.
Oh, goodness. Once again, the trouble on the baseline. Fumbled it out. Nice seal by Buford. We're moving those puppies, so important defensively. He's got that right angle and then behind some assistance.
4 to go. Buford only 1 of 8 in his last 8 shots. Oh, how about Joseph?
Nice hands, makes up for that turnover. Where are you going? Oh, goodness. Out of sorts and out of bounds. Tough combination. For the Cuse.
3:45 to go. Ohio State by 5. 60-55. See the field goal percentages at 40 and 37.
The big hands on the wings have to do a job, not give it an easy look in to Sullinger.
Deshaun Thomas, Buford. Lenzel Smith Jr. Look at that shifting zone. Smith puts it on the floor. A foul.
Oh my gosh. How about that? What a tough angle, Vern.
It's raining in here.
A ceiling scraper.
Lenzel Smith Jr. 12 points in this half. Trish leans in. Gets the roll.
He's tough with that pull up. State wisely clocks in their favor. Christmas concerned about Thomas. Sullinger might become available.
Christmas playing with 4 fouls. There's the baseline drive. saved somehow. No, it's not. Here comes Deion Waiters and Trish. And he's fouled by.
I think it might be Kraft.
I think it is.
You take your pick, but what an aggressive move. The toughness of Trish exhibiting itself in this open. It's an even break, but how about the angle he takes, realizing it's an opportunity for the two? But Smith, you mentioned, get the towel out. This is wet when that baby came down, but what a difficult angle. The toughness of Trish continues to exhibit itself with solid play with that pull-up.
And Brandon Trish at the line. Ouch. Kraft will stay on the floor with his four fouls with 2:18 to go. Trish, one more.
Here's to see if they step up to Dino to backing it off. Timeout, Ohio State.
2:12 to go. 4-point game.
And it's down the stretch. It's all about making plays. And the right guys to make the plays on each team. You think it's Sullinger on this end and the entry pass from either the top or the wing.
Now they start the play with 11 seconds to go in the shot clock. Here's Deshaun Thomas.
Wow! Oh, how about that? Now he's been quiet, but the ability to ISO and take advantage by the lefty.
Deion Waiters.
Gotta be careful. Lost it. He's on the end line. Boys, he's struggling. And a real talent, too. Now they got to get set with their press. No question about it. Touching right. It.
Each team with 11 turnovers now, and the press is put into effect. Lenzel Smith Jr. 90 seconds to go. Ooh, boy, dangerous pass. Good find, however. Kraft is looking at Chris Gent.
Well, he's saying run it.
Yes,
like
the assistant coach.
You slow the tree. Exactly. And I love teams that do that. Look at the big hands by Joseph. Pretty disruptive, couple of trips. But in other words, you keep your motion. You don't have to shoot it. Then you don't have to restart or reignite.
Chris Gent is in his first year as an assistant coach. And timeout called by Ohio State. He was a big player for the Buckeyes in 1992.
Nice trap, something different to show them.
In the hands of Sullinger, and he's fouled.
Ooh. Boy, you're in good shape out there. Late in the shot clock like that. They give it to Trish.
Foul is called on C.J. Fair. Sullinger, 6 of 8 at the line tonight.
And a good free throw shooter. I think the misses were fatigued more than anything.
Yeah.
76%.
Sutherland on for C.J. Fair.
Well, you got your three-point threat on a dribble drive.
The orange in this troubled season, beginning with those charges leveled against Bernie Fine back in November. There were allegations of violation of a drug policy. But most significant to this game tonight is the absence of Fab Mello suspended. There's Trish off the glass. Timeout called. Syracuse. More than 19,000 here in the garden tonight, the official attendance. And we are going to watch the final 61 seconds. Both teams, two timeouts now, both in the double bonus. And Ohio State leads by 6, trying to get back to the final 4 for the first time since 2007.
This is where you really got to be fundamental on your pass. They're looking for the foul. Right? They finally give it to him late. And that's number, if they give it, you know, they're looking around, maybe Trish
let's
or
see.
I think on Sutherland, and that's the limit. He was waiting for the foul back there. The catch, and right here, not, ooh, he got hit. Ooh. That's why he slowed down. That's why he slowed it down.
Yeah.
I was wondering what he was doing. He's been hit harder.
Yes, he has. High school quarterback from Findlay, Ohio. About an hour, as Sutherland fouls out.
Number 5, C.J. Fair.
and Kraft will go to the line. Finley, by the way, is the hometown of Ben Roethlisberger.
Oh, okay.
And we chatted with Aaron Kraft yesterday. He said, no, they've never met, but his girlfriend's family goes to the same church as the Roethlisberger family. So you just, all kinds of 6 degrees of separation.
Certainly do your due diligence, and you think of him and that touching story you gave about his brother.
Yeah.
I mean, just to carry that and play and have such great feelings.
Less than a minute to go. Aaron Kraft's brother, Brendan, deployed to Afghanistan, leaving sometime today or tonight.
At the quick hitters.
Joseph, yes.
They have some guys that can get to the rim, too. And very well sent the steal. And a foul.
They got
They got it. Well, that would have been a tough one. That would have been a three-point play. Goodness. Look at Kraft bringing his guys over to the sideline. Just the activity there by Waiters, who, as we mentioned, have a great talent, having a tough night, but comes up big. And Tristan, recipient with an opportunity for two.
And Aaron Kraft has fouled out. That's five on the sophomore. That's the hug from Greg Paulus on the bench. And Greg Paulus, interesting relationship to these two schools. He's the video coordinator, of course. He was a longtime point guard at Duke and used 1 year of remaining eligibility to go to his hometown, Syracuse, where he played quarterback for the Orange for 1 year.
And right now you have to be so fundamental with your passes, and that's key with Kraft out of the game for Ohio State against this pressure. Scott can handle it, but it's getting free, making the next decision, posting up. These are all the things you've drilled on.
4 point game. Smith gets it into Buford. Ooh, he was dangerously close.
They gave it away, yeah.
Yeah.
Take your pick down there, fair or Chris
and it's
Joseph.
Called on fair.
Look at the coach. I mean, he's amazing. That gushes talking about him and his attention to detail, his thought process about the game.
Lenzel Smith has hit some huge shots in the second half. He's 3 of 5 at the line, and he cans that one. And that one.
Big ones. And now you want to force clock of the Ohio State. Conversely, the quick hitter, nobody better than Waiters getting to the rim. That he normally spins and goes to his right hand, but the kid can finish with either one. How about the presence here? A little brush, drop step, and finish. Toughness personified.
Foul is on Sullinger, his third, and Deion Waiters, who has struggled tonight, is at the line to make this a one possession game.
72%. And they got to be ready on the inbounds.
Shannon Scott is on the floor, the freshman, and the foul is going to put Sullinger on the line.
Fair doing the right thing, stopping the clock. They try and get an initial trap and then slide for the steal. Stretch it out. That's all you want to do if you're Syracuse. Keep extending this game. Don't get on there too early, Jared.
He's 8 of 10 on the evening.
That's nice, huh?
Timeout, Ohio State.
Tough.
.1 to go in the game, and Syracuse really has done a terrific job, Bill, of staying in this thing, getting a clock stopped, succeeding at the free throw line. They're now down by 4.
And now the big thing now is getting the ball down the floor as quickly as possible and helping out on the ball screen by Ohio State.
Jumper, no. Rebound. Ohio State
got it.
And the foul.
And they had an outlet deep, but a very tough gamble at this particular time in the game. Pretty good defense challenging the jumper.
Deion Waiters has fouled out. And Lenzel Smith Jr. back at the line.
This kid's such a competitor, Waiters, and knows he didn't have his best game.
He has hit some huge free throws.
Yeah, they have done a nice job countering those quick giveaways.
And at the line, Ohio State now 26 of 37, make it 28 of 38. Still 18 seconds to go.
Go to the rim.
Trish. Nope. Buford. Sullinger.
Close time.
Buford.
And they give it on Jardine. Nope. Yeah, Scoop. Yeah.
Scoop Jardine, fifth-year senior. Came from the tough streets of South Philadelphia. Buford Kansas. He's the only senior in the Ohio State starting five.
You know, I had a chance to talk to Gene Smith before the game and saying what a tough year with all the difficulty with their football program. And the one solace was these kids, not only their success, but the type of kids that they have been. And Scoop gets a clean look. Wow.
Jardine hits the three. And the foul occurs with 1.9 to go. And a 5-point Ohio State edge.
It didn't come easy. No question Syracuse would be disappointed, but goodness, what a year. The ups and downs on and off the floor. And this man, pretty special coach.
One more. Thomas with two. Ohio State is headed to New Orleans. And the season comes to an end for the Orange of Syracuse. They wind up 34-3. Their only losses at Notre Dame in the Big East tournament and here to Ohio State.
So two berths in the Final Four have been claimed. Just moments ago, it was Ohio State, the Buckeyes, with a 77-70 victory, and Thad Matta has led his team to the Final Four. Well, how did they do it? Well, they got off to a very strong start, 9-2 early, before Jared Sullinger got into foul trouble and before Deion Waiters was making plays like that. Syracuse hanging tough early. Aaron Kraft, though, the spectacular point guard. Seen him weave his way in there, drawing contact from the bigger man and laying it in, plus the foul. With Chris Joseph, top scorer all year long. Keeping Syracuse in it. By Cada for the slam. Jardine, the half-court alley-oop for C.J. Fair. Nobody got back. And Syracuse was starting to roll. This was tight all the way through the end of the first half. Amir Williams knocking it down. Deshaun Thomas in the lane. Syracuse tying it up with Rakeem Christmas, 29 all at the break. Early in the second half, Buckeyes with a two-point lead, but Jardine finds Christmas to tie it at 33 all. Then Jardine finding Sutherland in the corner. He's got great range. Sullinger, after spending three quarters of the first half on the bench with foul troubles, really broke out in the second half. And how about the body control there from Chris Joseph? Buckeyes, though, were still up seven. Lenzel Smith putting the Buckeyes up four. Next possession, Jardine looking for Trish. Wide open for a three. The Orange back within one. 6 minutes to go. William Buford down low. Sullinger, jump hook off the window. Buckeyes by three. They were up seven when Trish hit this tough shot. Make it a five-point game. And Thomas, look at this off-balance drive, lays it in with the left. Deion Waiters in the final minute, trying to cut the lead in half, which he did, made it a one-possession game after a free throw. Big possession there, cleared by Ohio State. They go on to win it. 77-70, the final. A look at the numbers shows neither team shot it great, right around 40%. And Ohio State going to the line a whole lot more and out-rebounding the Orangemen by significant matters. Now, let's listen to the reaction.
Very pleased head coach. They had nothing to it, right? An easy walk in the park.
I tell you, Vern, that was an incredible college basketball game. And as we told these guys, it was going to come down to people making plays. You know, fortunately, we got Jared out of foul trouble. He got going in the second half. But every guy in this team made a big play one way or another. And that was the difference in the game.
Well, you had to get to halftime with Jared on the bench and with Ravenel on the bench. And you managed to do that. That was really
honestly incredible. Amir Williams was tremendous tonight, and you know, he was a presence in there, and these guys really rallied around him, and you know, it was a great team win for us.
We're not going to get the smile off Jared Sullinger's face for a while, or Aaron Kraft, Bill.
The foul problems, lamenting them, but were you pent up, ready to go come second half?
I couldn't wait for the second half. I mean, honestly, I want to thank all the media that doubted us. All the questions they asked about this team's toughness, and this team came out and we played hard. And I wouldn't want to do it with any other guys, man. I'm so proud of them guys behind me. And for all the media, thank you. I appreciate it.
Everybody steps up for this team, but I think your mom's concerned about your derriere. You used it pretty wisely in the second half.
I had to. My mom blessed me with a booty, and I just had to use it.
Hey, listen. When you fell down, you were like an assistant coach over there.
I was trying to do my best, you know, just trying to get down, get everyone together, trying to have our freshman point guard get some good experience. And, you know, gotta give a lot of credit to those guys, man. They got stops when they needed to, knocked down free throws. I'm really proud, really proud.
Was the zone a puzzle for you at first to try and get the ball inside?
It definitely is. I mean, we could try to simulate in practice, but you can't do it with their length and the way they played it all year. So I think we did a good job in the first half attacking it, and they made adjustments, we made some adjustments. Big boy over here came through for us, and you know, it's just a great win, great team win.
How special is this for you with your brother going to Afghanistan?
It's awesome. The only thing that make it better is he's here with me right now, but I know he's here in spirit, and just keep praying for him, and everything will be all right.
God bless. Congratulations to both of you. Coach.